What is up? It's your boy Silos. Welcome to the Silos Collectibles. And we are going to finish off the Coward finale. And it's called Too Late, page 111. Where Leo, basically on the last episode, he finds out that something's up. Because they left a message at this one guy's house that they're going to go, and they figured out where the barn is at. And that's where Greta's hideout is at, right? So Leo drives over there and pulls up far away because he doesn't want nobody to know that he pulled up, and he parks, sees the light on, and he's just hoping that he's not too late, like it says right there. Right? So page 112, Leo opens the door to the barn and finds Greta on the floor, shot dead, and Leo's in shock, right? So Seymour walks up behind him and tells him that Delron is not easy to convince about Leo having the briefcase. So they left Seymour to basically shoot Leo and take him out, plus the briefcase. So now Seymour walks Leo at the walks Leo back to the car and tells him, you know, that the drugs are in the car, in the briefcase, in the back part of the, in the trunk, you know, basically. So So Leo walks with them all the way back to the car, to where the briefcase is at. And now we move on to page 115. Opens the trunk and shows them that the briefcase is there. But basically there's a key missing. Why? Because the uncle overdosed on it. So now there's about to be a second key missing, which he, Leo cuts it, tosses it at his face, automatically overdosed, and shoots him right in the forehead, right? So now we move on to 117, where Leo says he should have asked where the girl was before he shot him, because now he doesn't know where he's at. But he pocket searches him and finds the keys to a motel called The Lark. Goes back to the barn, closes Greta's eyes, and burns the barn down. Because the spot is also burned, right? So he has to burn everything, and there's a death, murder scene, pictures, and all that stuff. So since that was his hiding spot, they had to burn the spot down. Plus, his uncle is buried behind that barn. So we move on to page 118, where cops been called to go turn off the fire, and now they're investigating because, you know, somebody's been tipped off. He drives to the motel, and who does he see come out? Delron. Goes straight to the ice machine. He pulls his gun out, walks up behind Delron, but Delron notices something. He swings the bucket of ice, punches Leo. He goes back, breaks the window, cuts himself. He has shards on his shoulders now, or on his back, right? Grabs him, tells him, you're about to shoot me. But in the process that he grabs him, like right here, Delron tells him that he's gonna basically pay and do something to the little girl, right? But he doesn't notice that Leo took his little side knife and cuts him in the vital organs, which is the leg and the throat. Delron bleeds out. He walks in. The girl's there, right? So her name's Angie, by the way. Now we move on to page 122. And he saves her, but she's scared. And she doesn't want to go, but he tells her to trust him because he knows her mom, and he doesn't want to tell her that she's dead. So he just takes her to a safe place, and now they go to Marley's bar, right? He drives to the old bar, basically. And now that he pulls up, he's in bad shape. Leo's bleeding heavy because he got cut up and barely makes it. Gnarly's chilling, you know, and he gets up and he's like, Jesus, kid, like, what's up? What the hell is going on? He calls him kid, by the way, so he asks Leo, like, what's up? What does he do? And Leo replies, he didn't do enough because, you know, what he meant by that is that they killed Greta, so he didn't do enough. So Gnarly looks at the kid, meaning Angie, and she's there scared. She doesn't know what's going on. She's been kidnapped, and she saw what they did to her grandma when Del Ron killed her. So she's like super scared, and she doesn't even know these people. But Leo saved her, you know. So she's somewhat like confused. So we move on to page 124. Leo's bleeding heavy, and basically, Gnarly checks him out and he passes out. He blanks out, and all he remembers is Gnarly's ripping his bandages off and all that to, you know, see what's going on under there, because he has like shards of glass and all that, right? So he wakes up, and he's still at Gnarly's bar, right? So he's on his couch where Gnarly does his phone calls and all that stuff in his office. He walks up to the room where he has drugs and the, you know, because it's a bar, so people they confiscate stuff like weapons or knives, stuff that's not allowed in the club. So drugs is one of them. He takes some painkillers and he's on his way. Now we move on to page 126, and Leo leaves him a message talking about it's all there and to walk away, let's call it even, because everybody's looking for him, you know. So he takes the briefcase to royalty, and Leo follows, parks in the corner, and what does he do? He throws a cocktail to the Hummer that it's royalties that's parked outside, but it's two bodyguards, you know, they're keeping safe on that front door. Hummer's over there in the corner, and they're telling him, get your ass in there, you're in big trouble, or whatever, you know, what you do. So he's not in good favor right now, so they're on his ass. Leo throws the cocktail bottle to the Hummer, it blows up, catches on fire. And Leo runs to the alley where these two guys are at, and he tells them, hey, there's a car on fire out there. And they're like, Royals V, meaning the Humvee. And as they go over there, since he's a good pocket picker or pickpocketer, he takes the chain with the keys to the door, opens the door up, and when he was at the club or at the spot where at the old bar, there was a machine gun there that he took that he's gonna pull out later, right? So check this out. He pulls up, he walks up behind, he hides in the shadows because he sees people there, and homie's doing showing royalty that, you know, he has the stuff. And Royalty asks where Del Ron is at, and he's like, oh, probably with that little girl being a pervert. And now they pull up, or they open the briefcase, and he's all satisfied and tells him he's lucky. Now that you're gonna have a few bucks, don't go disappearing on me. But that's his plan, you know? And somehow Leo either gets the gun from somewhere in that spot, or he gets the gun from the bar where he was at, right, before he took the drugs. He starts blasting. He gets Royal right in the face, and two in the chest, one in the face. He goes down. Bullets start flying. His two bodyguards that are in there start shooting, but Leo gets him. And in the process, homie freaking ducks under the table, shoots Leo twice in the chest. Leo goes down. And now he thinks he's dead, right? So, well, he doesn't think he's dead, but he's in no position of doing anything. The two bodyguards walk up. So now that the two bodyguards heard the gunshots, they walk in, and this guy just starts shooting because he's dead either way. And they're gonna think it's a setup, and their boss is dead, because that's what they're asking, you know, like, Roy, where you at? And he shoots them. They're dead. He walks out. But if you see, Leo's gone. He goes to the corner or through the back alley, sneaks up behind this guy right here, shoots him up. Seymour goes down. Once Seymour goes down, this guy goes down. And that's where it all ends right there. We're going to continue on Lawless. So if you have any questions about what I'm not explaining, or if you read this story, put it down in the comments below. Thank you guys for watching. And that's it. We're done, officially done with episode 5 of Coward. So we did a total of 5 episodes to complete Coward, which is all this right here. And 5 episodes, it was a lot. We got to know the characters. We got to know the villains, the good guys, the people that are involved, the plot. And that's it. So stick around, and I'm going to upload another video. So don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe one more time, all right? Peace.